Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, we'll cover how to troubleshoot a suction line pressure transducer. To ensure the pressure transducer is reading correctly, first verify the pressure transducer is correct for the application. The model number as well as range should be marked on the unit. For most refrigerant, the controllers use a 0 to 150 psia or absolute transducer. For R410A, the controllers use a 0 to 300 PSIG or gage transducer. And finally, CO2 uses a 0 to 500 PSIG or gage pressure transducer. Once a transducer is confirmed to be matched to the refrigerant selected, the next step is to verify the sensor's reading. Many times, this can be done by simply attaching a calibrated gage set to the same suction line and verifying the readings are similar. If this is not possible or the readings do not match, the sensor reading can be verified using a multimeter. The first step, and I know this can sound silly, is to identify the cable from the pressure transducer. It contains three wires, red, black, and green. Validate the sensors connect to the controller and that the cable between the sensor and the controller has not been damaged. You'd be surprised how many times we catch the problem right here. Once the integrity of the cable and the connection are verified, identify and confirm each wire is connected to the correct position on the controller. Now that the sensor model and wiring are confirmed, it is time to verify the pressure reading itself. To do this, you'll need to have your multimeter ready and set to read DC volts. With the red probe to the red wire and the black probe to the black wire, confirm the voltage is reading positive or plus 5 volts. If this reading is correct, proceed to the next step. If not, determine why you're not getting the correct reading. Next, move the red probe to the green wire's position and measure the voltage. Note, this reading will be used to calculate the pressure read by the controller. Now's the part where we have to use math. And we know for many of you, this may not be your favorite part, but trust us, it looks worse than it is. Use the voltage reading taken between the green and black wires into the following equation. As you can see in the equation, the first thing you need to do is subtract 0.5 volts or half a volt from the reading. Next, divide the new number by 4. Since this is the range of the pressure transducer. Finally, multiply this number by the range of the transducer. So for most refrigerants, this is 150. If you find your result is 14.7 pounds below what you thought it should be, don't worry. This is because it is an absolute transducer. The controller automatically converts the pressure to gauge, since that's what we're used to seeing. The engineers used an absolute transducer for those of you that need really cold saturation temperature to meet your customer needs. So it's that simple. In a few steps, you're able to go from a DC voltage reading to what the controller is reading. For more information, please visit our website or contact our technical support line.